oil, switchgrass, or anything else you can name. We are going to have to make other arrangements for how we occupy the terrain in North America and for the activities that we do and for the culture that goes along with that to make those activities happen. I want to say a few words about the current oil situation, and I'm not going to do the primer on what is called peak oil, a term that I tend to try to avoid because it has sort of cultish overtones. It's not a cult, but you know, people have begun to place it in the Sasquatch folder unjustly. But I tend to call it the global energy predicament. And it's certainly true, it's a fact, it's real, it's facing us, and it is coming down at us pretty hard. And what has become understood about it over the last 18 months is very interesting. Probably the primary thing is, now that we've had a year or so looking back, there are a couple of things that we know about the oil supply. We know that the greatest amount of sheer liquid crude oil that was ever pumped out of the ground, the peak of liquid crude oil, was in May of 2005. We can tell from the production figures. We also know that the total number of all liquids, including not just the crude oil, but also the natural gas condensates and all the other exotic other things that go into the basic oil package, the total amount of that peaked in July of 2006, and we can see that in the figures. July 2006, the world was pumping about 84 million plus barrels a day. Excuse me, about 85 million plus barrels a day. And now, a year later, we're about a million barrels a day under that. And one of the reasons that we're not feeling that is because those million barrels a day that we've lost have basically been sacrificed by the silent, suffering people in the third world who are simply opting out of the futures markets, and they're not buying the oil anymore. And they're increasingly not using it to do what they do, to run their tractors, to run their water pumps, etc. But the next thing that will happen is when the third world demand is finally, we run out of that, is that the contest will begin between the first world nations. Now that contest is beginning to resolve around another thing that we're beginning to understand, the oil export crisis. And what we've discovered is that if the depletion rate around the world is, let's say, 3% a year, what we've discovered is that the export rates decline at an even greater, steeper rate. So if the production depletion rate of the oil coming out of the ground is 3% less year over year, the export rate will be 7 to 11% less. And not only that, it will accelerate even more over time, so that within 5 years, our exports will be down by more than half. Excuse me, our import, the imports that we get from the exporting nations. And the exporting nations are the obvious ones we know about: Saudi Arabia, Russia, Iran, Venezuela, Mexico, etc., Norway, Nigeria. The United Kingdom, which owned half of the North Sea, they pissed away all of their exportability, and now they're net importers of energy again after 20 years of having a cheap oil fiesta. And the poster child for all of this really is Mexico. And Mexico is a special source of imports for us for a number of reasons. First of all, it's our number two source of imports, only after Canada and ahead of Saudi Arabia. So we get a lot, we have been getting a lot of oil from them. Mexico is also special in this sense. They don't have to put their oil on tankers to get it to the United States. They can just put it on pipelines. Okay, so it's a lot easier and cheaper to get it here than to get it from Saudi Arabia or Norway or Nigeria or any other place. Now, the Mexican oil industry is kind of special because two-thirds of all of its oil comes from one giant field, the Cantarell oil field, one of the greatest supergiant fields ever found. It was discovered rather late in the oil industry story, and it was drilled and exploited with the latest and greatest technology. And of course, there are diminishing returns to technology and unintended consequences, and we don't pay attention to these things, right? Because we're in love with technology, we have this religious kind of infatuation with it. Well, the greatest effect of all that technology on the Cantarell field was that it only depleted it more efficiently. The same thing that happened in the North Sea. You know, so every time we fool ourselves by saying, oh, we'll get new technology and we'll just drill more efficiently or explore more efficiently, well, we're also going to run out of our oil more efficiently. But the thing about Mexico is that two-thirds of its oil industry depends on the oil from the Cantarell oil field, which is now seeing the steepest depletion rates of any oil fields in the world. A minimum of 15% a year, and this year actually the actual figures are showing 17% for this year alone. And what that means is that within 24-36 months, Mexico will not have any ability to import, to export any oil to the importer, namely us. So we're going to lose the number two source of our imports within a year or two, maybe 36 months at the most. And you know, why is this happening? Why is this oil export crisis happening? Why are the export depletion, the export rates steeper than the depletion rates? Well, because not only are these countries suffering depletion, but they're also using more of their own oil. A lot more of their own oil.